I hold no pride or allegiance to a place that I just happened to be born into. Two kids with some pretty serious emotional issues had sex in a trailer in Bucyrus, Ohio, and 9 months later I popped out. I've never viewed that as cause for a celebration. From what I've seen, a mourning would be more appropriate to the death of the hopes and dreams of those two kids. Years later, I'd find myself climbing up on top of the jewelry store on Sandusky Avenue, and I'd let my toes hang out over the ledge and think about jumping off out onto the street. And I'd daydream about who would find my body and who would come to my funeral. I'm trying really hard not to think like that anymore. Now, saying these things out loud just kind of helps me sort them out inside my head. Cause I've been trying really hard to figure out who I am. So like most stories I've ever heard before, I thought it'd start at the beginning. Now I sat down to try and write something beautiful, but the truth is I don't have anything resembling beauty inside of me. And that's a hard realization, that I am just a lost generation. I am a real live American throwaway. Now most nights I lie awake in bed, worrying that I'm a sociopath, and that I worry so much about that. And I throw these social and digital Hail Marys out into the ether, because my family doesn't get me, and my friends, they don't either. Now I sat down to try and write something beautiful, but the truth is I don't have anything resembling beauty inside of me. And that's a hard realization, that I am just a lost generation. I am a real live American throwaway. And like most stories you've ever heard before, I thought it started at the beginning.